Thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Nick Smith. I'm the product marketing manager for our 2.4 gigahertz connectivity team here at TI. And I'm excited to talk a little bit about Matter and the TI products associated with Matter. So first, introducing the Matter protocol. You may have heard about it. It was released and developed by the Connectivity Standards Alliance, which is formerly the Zigbee Alliance. And it's a royalty-free protocol that runs on top of IP-based transport layers, like, for instance, Wi-Fi and Thread. And then it uses Bluetooth Low Energy for commissioning. And essentially what it is a standard application interface that allows devices from different ecosystems or different manufacturers to communicate natively and access the Matter ecosystem, which is primarily targeted for homes. So as the connectivity space, and again, specifically in phones, has continued to develop, you can see, you know, from Ethernet to Wi-Fi to Zigbee to Bluetooth to Thread, the environment in the home has gotten a bit fragmented regarding which connectivity protocols are being used. And the ambition of the Matter protocol, which was just had the spec release a couple of months ago, is to unify the fragmentation within the home. So expanding on that, why is Matter an important protocol to know about and pay attention to? Number one, interoperability. That's what I was alluding to before. Matter-enabled devices will work seamlessly within the home ecosystem environment, mostly because the big home ecosystem players like Apple, Amazon, or Google actually all came together to help drive, develop, and release Matter. Additionally, major silicon vendors, end product creators have all come together for this Matter protocol. And that means that home networks will no longer have to be locked into a specific ecosystem. As long as the devices are Matter enabled, they'll all be able to communicate natively. So, you know, if you go out to the store and buy a light bulb or buy a certain digital home assistant or a certain door lock, and all of those are Matter enabled, you will have the assurance that they will be able to communicate natively. On the technology side, Matter, as I mentioned, enables IP. So it has a very natural connection to the cloud or to the internet. And it leverages Wi-Fi or Thread as the transport protocol. Additionally, Matter is open source, and there's source code on GitHub available for everyone. Security, Matter provides built-in security features such as verification, and as part of the qualification of a Matter certified device, you'll have to meet certain security standards built into the protocol. And then ease of use, again, I mentioned Matter would run on top of IP-based networks like Wi-Fi or Thread, but it enables the use of smartphones either via Wi-Fi or Bluetooth to commission devices into the Matter network. And then finally, ultra-low power. This is something that TI helps uniquely bring to the table with Matter. Is it's designed to be in both standby and active mode. And throughout the development of Matter, the Connectivity Standards Alliance has worked closely with silicon vendors like TI to make sure that the next generation devices that will run the Matter protocol have the ability to be at a very low power so that you can have battery powered home automation devices. And then finally, faster time to market. As you would be developing a home device or an end product, you can leverage, again, open source resources and code for Matter. It's supported by more than 500 member companies who are part of the Connectivity Standards Alliance, including, you know, product creators, ecosystem creators, and silicon vendors. And then again, all these Matter certified products are interoperable. So you can focus on the expertise and releasing the right product rather than having to worry about the ecosystem of connectivity standards in the environment that the product will deploy to. So a quick look at the Matter topology. So again, I mentioned this before, but Matter is an application layer protocol that runs on the application layer of the underlying transport layer, meaning an IP-based network like Wi-Fi or Thread. So Matter, as you can see in the diagram, is an application layer protocol to make sure that these devices can communicate. And you can see in the image an example of how a Matter network could look, all centered around your Wi-Fi access point, for example, with IP connectivity to the cloud. You could have a Wi-Fi connection to a digital home assistant that would be acting as a Matter border router. And then you could talk over Thread to an HVAC system or a fan or a light bulb that is Matter enabled, so it can naturally talk to the border router, to the access point, into the cloud, all over an IP-based network. And being Matter certified, all of these devices could come from different vendors. And then I also mentioned, if you look at the smartphone, you have both the option to commission over Wi-Fi. So in this example, it's showing a thermostat being commissioned over Wi-Fi and then talking directly over Wi-Fi, Matter-enabled Wi-Fi, to an access point. You also have the option to commission over Bluetooth Low Energy. So if you want to commission, for instance, a light bulb device that doesn't have Wi-Fi, there's hardware available that can run both Matter and Bluetooth Low Energy, and that Bluetooth Low Energy commissioning is built into the spec. And then talking about some of the unique advantages that TI brings as a partner for the Matter protocol. Number one, industry leadership. So TI has been in the connectivity business for over 20 years. We have a portfolio that contains pretty much every connectivity protocol, but we've also been a board member of the Connectivity Standards Alliance for over 10 years, or since the beginning of the Zigbee Alliance. And we've been very active in the development of Matter itself. We also are a contributor to the Thread group, which again, Thread is one of the underlying protocols that Matter can run on top of. And we're a Wi-Fi Alliance member. So again, another one of the protocols that Matter can run on top of. So we're very involved in the development of these technologies. We partner to make sure that we can release the right hardware and software tools to support these protocols when they come to market. And then a flexible portfolio of hardware. We support, as I mentioned, most connectivity standards out there today, anything from sub 1 GHz band to 2.4, including Bluetooth, low energy, Thread, Zigbee, or Wi-Fi. So we have a wide set of devices to support a wide set of protocols, meaning that if you want to run a Thread Matter device with BLE commissioning, we have an option for that. If you want to run a Wi-Fi device with Matter and Wi-Fi commissioning, we also have an option for that. And we have a couple of devices that you can get started with today for Matter, and I'll talk about those coming up here. I mentioned low power earlier. Our Thread Matter devices enable the industry's lowest power solutions. We have features including less than 1 microamp standby current, and that means with RAM retention on the device and a real-time clock running, we can be consuming less than a microamp of current. And also over temperature, that's very stable, which is not always the case with devices. So if, you know, something was deployed outside or in the attic in Texas where I'm located and it's very hot, our power consumption performance would still be very stable over that variation in temperature. And then finally, we have the option for various different output powers of our devices to increase the output power and increase the range. And we have very low power consumption, particularly at a mode with 10 dBm output power. to support whatever network topology is needed. And then finally, integrated security features. I mentioned that Matter does have some built-in security features as part of the certification. So what we focus on our devices is make sure that we put hardware enablers on the devices that help enhance the efficiency and security of the Matter protocol. So we have over 30 security enablers, and particularly on our Wi-Fi devices, that can help protect against cybersecurity-based attacks in partnership with the security that's built into the Matter protocol. And then finally, some of the devices that are supported. So this is broken into Thread and Wi-Fi devices. And there are multiple different configurations that you could run for a Matter topology. So if we're looking at the Thread example, you could have the device acting as a radio or network coprocessor with an additional host in the system, meaning an additional MCU or an additional Linux-based processor. And as you look at the lower memory devices at the top, like the 2651 or the 2340, this would be the configuration that those devices would be able to run in based on the memory resources available. And then if you look at the towards the bottom of the Thread devices that have more memory, the very bottom one in particular has up to 704K of flash. It has 256K of ROM that would hold the BLE stack, and then it has 144K of RAM plus 8K of cache. And this device is optimized to be a total solution for Thread-based Matter, meaning it can be the only system on chip, the only SoC in the system. It could run Bluetooth Low Energy, Thread, and Matter, and could run at a very low power consumption. This device also has the option for the integrated power amplifier that I mentioned earlier, giving you access to the higher output powers to increase your range on the device. And then on the Wi-Fi side, the 3230 and 35, these are options for a Wi-Fi SoC running Matter that also have coexistence with Bluetooth Low Energy. So you would use another device for the Bluetooth Low Energy, but this has built-in features for the Wi-Fi and the BLE to coexist in the network. Additionally, there's options for both the 2.4 gigahertz band Wi-Fi and also the 5 gigahertz band Wi-Fi. So as you can see, with the exception of the 2340R5, all of these devices are already in production today. So that means that you can go on ti.com today, find any of these devices, find the software development kit and the evaluation board, and you could be up and running with a Matter-based example immediately. And to find those resources and the devices I talked about, and really an overview of TI's offering for Matter, you can go to ti.com/matter, and that will have everything in one place to learn more or to get started with TI's Matter solution. So with that, I will pause and see if there are any questions. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Nick. Thank you everyone for attending today's MPU webinar. The recording and PDF version of the slides will be available at ti.com/MPU. We hope to see you next week for the next topic, Achieving Power Designs with TI's new Buck Power Module, TPSM63610. If you have any final questions, please feel free to ask them via chat. Otherwise, have a great day.